Catch a wave and you're sitting on top of the world.
Hello, I'm Brian Keane.
And I'm Sam Enright. Today we would like to introduce an enticing new business venture.
We plan on dropping a California surf shop here onto the suburban East Coast. We believe that transplanting a coastal surf shop into a suburban upper middle class area less than 2 hours from the beach would be highly profitable. The name for our idea is called Shore Break Surf Shop. We're looking to sell surfers and non-surfers alike based upon the idea that it's not just surfers who are attracted to the surf culture and styles. Using our own experience and research, we have seen that in many upper middle class areas less than 2 hours from the beach, the surf culture has a heavy influence on people ages 10 to 50. The reason we want to locate in a non-coastal area is simple. Surf shops in coastal areas are already vast, and the competition is stiff. The pros of locating inland far outweigh the cons. People want to wear surf and skate clothing, regardless if they surf or skate or not. Located in an upper middle class area, we'll sell high-end clothing and apparel. The market is developing, and we believe the intercoastal areas need a surf shop that is actually legitimate, compared to stores like PacSun, Mizumi's, and Hollister, which sell clothing that is not really what the culture is all about. Our surf shop would carry brands such as Billabong, Quiksilver, Maddox, RVCA, Hurley, Burton, Ezekiel Designs, DVS Shoes, Fox, and Lost.
We will also supply up-and-coming and environmentally friendly brands that are all about surf culture. So what makes us different? We're using a concept that has already had a strong influence on most of America, in coastal and intercoastal areas. Because we are competing with very large franchise businesses such as PacSun, Hollister, and Zumiez, we must use a different business plan to succeed. The problem with these stores is they have a difficult time keeping up with current trends and changing fashion. PacSun has locations across the United States. Their stores all carry the same merchandise, and it's easy for them to fall behind. A key difference is we will be able to pick up merchandise based upon the immediate area around our shop. This gives us a great advantage over the franchise businesses. Because we are younger, we'll be more aware about the newest trends and also be able to be more adaptable to change. So we are a surf shop, but due to our far proximity from the ocean, it's not feasible for us to carry a large stock of surfboards. Instead, we're going to focus on a small stock of higher-end boards that would appeal to someone in the higher-income family.
The reason we picked the name Shore Break Surf Shop is because it's catchy and also very easy to be stylish. They have a cool design and a cool logo that really make it catchy and stand out. It's also a very catchy name, Shore Break Surf Shop. It's actually a tongue twister, a lot of S's, to make it very easy to remember. Also, the shop is a very retro California-ish look. It's multiple colors, it's very appealing to the eye, which will definitely attract a lot of customers. Especially when it's not in a strip mall and it's actually off by itself, which will again attract more people. All ages can shop here. It's going to be bright and well lit, which is with very good staff, which goes against stores like PacSun and Hollister, which are very dark, have a very young customer base, as well as a young staff base, which is completely contrary to what we're trying to do. We're not trying to pander to just the tweeners. We're going for everyone from ages 10 to 50, more of a family environment, which will, we believe, generate more profit.
Many surf shops are seasonal. Because they're located on vacation areas, they only have a peak season of a few months during the summer. The key difference with our surf shop is it's going to be located in a residential area, which has steady business all year. Billabong is one of the United States' top clothing distributors for surfwear. As you can see on this graph, sales do fluctuate in the summer months, but there's still a profit off-season.
Thanks for listening to our business plan.
We hope to see you out there.